When Batman was training, what if there was another person that trained as well as Batman, but decided killing was the better option? This is the Comic Story and Channel, where we take some of your favorite trade paperback single issues and we break them down into digestible bites, and then I read them dramatically back to you. And today we're going to be covering Batman issues 101 to 105, I believe. The Ghostmaker storyline. Now, just so you understand what's going on, this is following the Joker War, which is another video we have right here at the Comic Story and Channel. But now that the Joker War is done, Batman is missing a lot of his money. He's currently still dating Catwoman, and most of his sidekicks are back, including Nightwing. Also, Harley Quinn is now working with Batman. So this begins the brand new storyline that is Batman, how things are going to change, who the new characters are, and how Ghostmaker is going to be involved in a much larger role of his life. I hope you guys enjoy. We did wait for this whole story to finish up to give it to you. And if you do enjoy what we do here, please consider hitting like and subscribe as they will really help out the channel. All right, let's get into it. Batman 101. As Batman and Catwoman look over the city of Gotham, Batman thinks back to how it all used to feel. Not at the beginning of it all, but at the height of it all. When everything was working so well. He'd be at the manor when the bat signal would turn on. He'd meet Jim on the old rooftop and get some clue that would start the hunt for whoever was terrorizing the city that night. Before he knew it, he was on the case. Sometimes alone, sometimes with a partner. Shortly after, he'd go back to the cave with Alfred telling him to eat or drink something to get some sleep. But he wouldn't because he was right at the edge of uncovering something and the process would start all over again. Now, there was no signal. There was no Gordon, and there was no Robin at his side. There's no Alfred in the cave. There's no approximating the old Gotham anymore. There's only remembering. Catwoman scoffs, telling him that he has that look on his face and it's insufferable. She could picture him sitting at the table with the Justice League doing it. He's made his decision and it's going to change both their lives. It's the right decision and he knows it. And he also knows that it's going to hurt. So say it. Put it into actual words. Batman pauses for a moment and then he tells her, Joker was right. I've been doing it all wrong. For longer than I care to admit, which means I'm going to need to change. He jumps and Catwoman follows, asking what will he do now? And Batman tells her, I'm going to move into the city. There's a brownstone I didn't even know I owned. If I'm going to be operating more lo-fi, I'm going to do it from the inside. It's time to start building a life without Alfred, to see and feel the beating heart of Gotham City. And how to do it alone without pushing anyone else away. Catwoman pauses and asks him, what about her? And Batman goes on stating that he needs to ground himself. This city is about to get much more dangerous than it has ever been before. The Joker was right about that. He can't rely on the old systems. He'll have to develop an entirely new way of being Batman. Catwoman sighs, telling him that he can't do that with a partner who is one of the most wanted women in the city. And Batman tells her that after robbing the Underbroker, the entire criminal underworld is going to have its target on destroying her. She then says that there's another option. They could leave the city together. Both take new identity, start a new life somewhere else entirely. Be something new. But that'll never happen. So, 1 year. She will give him 1 year to figure it all out. That's how long it will take her to sort out her new enemies and clear her name enough. They can do this properly. After that, they'll make some real decision about how to do this right, about how they can actually be together. Batman calls out to her, but Catwoman turns back, telling him to just shut up. If this is how they need to play this, then this is how they'll play it. But don't waste another minute talking about tonight. All right? As she leans in for a kiss, she pulls back, asking if he's going to show her the new place. And Batman tells her, there isn't any furniture. And she laughs. Who needs furniture? So the next night, Batman goes out on patrol to take down some of the diehard Joker clowns, calling themselves the Grinners. Barbara radios in that these guys are mostly hired guns working for the costumed set, and they float around from boss to boss. But the Grinners are a bit too strange and too lethal to rely on. The Smile Bar has been their choice of hangout for years, going back to the Harley days. They tend to stay quiet during the lulls between the Joker's big crimes. And Batman tells her that's why he never shut the place down. It's valuable to know exactly when they start getting ready for a big attack. And right now, I need answers. Barbara asks if this is about the Clown Hunter. He's trying to get rid of the targets before he could kill anyone else. And Batman kicks in the door with Barbara telling him that that's strange. He isn't registering on her body map. It's on loop. They've been played. Get out of there. It could be a trap. Batman looks at the dozens of murdered clowns, stating, "No, it's a message." Barbara goes through the surveillance, stating that these guys, doesn't the clown hunter go around with a bat? These men have stab wounds. Batman sees an image sprayed onto the wall, and it tells him, "This isn't the clown hunter. This is something else. Deactivate the computer systems now! Maintain radio silence until contacted. I'll explain when this is all over." Barbara yells for him not to cut her out. She's going to help him through whatever this is, and Batman tells her, "I'm sorry, but this is personal." Later, as the sun comes up, the clown hunter watches from across a building as Harley Quinn begins to settle into her new apartment, stating that someone should get her a real nice housewarming present. You know, while they still have the chance. Clown hunter takes out his phone and continues playing the video that he has loaded up, stating, "Now that you have all the necessary components, you're ready to build your homemade rocket launcher." Clown hunter laughs. "Thank you, internet. I sure am ready." And then a voice tells him, "We're not so sure. Seems like a good way to blow yourself up." Clown hunter spins back, grabbing his back, seeing a man in a white costume and mask covering his face, asking, "Can your mind read my phone or something?" And the man laughs, "No, not personally, but my suit can. And your search history is a real treat. As always, the next generation blazes bold new trails through taboo." Clown hunter tells him, "I don't think I like you." And the man tells him, "You shouldn't. You're about to blow up an apartment, and you're a wanted criminal." The man grabs his sword and the clown hunter responds, "Yeah, I really don't like you." Just then Batman punches the masked man, telling him, "That makes two of us, Ghost Maker." The man responds, "Batman." Batman gets into a defensive stance. "We had an agreement. This is my city." And the Ghost Maker tells him, "Then you should probably do your damned job then. The city is rotting from the inside out. But you still won't do what must be done to save it, Batman." Ghostmaker lunges at the clown hunter, but Batman blocks the attack. "I won't let you hurt the boy." And Ghostmaker tells him, "Then we'll just do it like we did when we were younger. How about it, Batman? We fight for it." Batman tells him, "I won't play that game." And Ghostmaker kicks him, telling him, "You're missing the whole scale of the thing. I'm not saying the winner takes the boy. I'm saying the winner takes Gotham." Barbara comes over the comms, telling him that she can't see whoever he is fighting. From every angle, he disappears, and his voice is distorted. Batman tells her that she won't get a record on him. She won't find his name in any international database either. She needs to stop trying to get a look at him. If she brushes up against his ghost net, his computer will eat hers alive. Barbara asks, "Who the hell is this person?" And Batman tells her, "He's the Ghost Maker, and he's not supposed to be here." Ghost Maker slashes at him, telling him, "That's exactly how it's supposed to sound. You used to make fun of the name, remember? You said you didn't need a pseudonym or a mask to fight crime in Gotham. How long did it take for you to start calling yourself the Batman? A week? A night?" Barbara shouts, asking, "What are you saying? I can't get a read on him." Batman grabs Ghostmaker by the cape, slamming his head into a wall, telling her, "He's upset that I made fun of him when we were 15 years old. And you're about to learn how he's going to be even more upset that he hasn't won a match between us since we were 20. Ghostmaker leans off the wall, asking, "You want to know what I did today? I've been in Gotham for 12 hours. I leaked the activities of 14 different district judges to the Gotham Gazette. I solved a string of murders that the police couldn't link together. I also sent the FBI the location of 6 incoming shipments of heavy artillery. That was before I left my plane, Batman! And now look, you're protecting a child like the clown hunter, who has already been twisted into an unrepentant killer!" Batman tells the clown hunter to run, but as the clown hunter leaps over the ledge, the ghost maker quickly follows behind. Batman chases after him, grabbing one of the dropped swords, slamming it through the ghost maker's cape and into the ground, stopping him from going any further. Ghost maker rips his cape off, telling him, "I don't even care about the child. It's more what he represents. The same fight that we've been having for years. This is all too personal for you. You care too much to save your city. And now the kid will be killed in front of you, so maybe you will get a clear head at what a terrible job you're doing." Batman grits his teeth, "You're a psychopath." And Ghostmaker gets ready to attack. "Yes, yes I am. That's exactly why I'm better." Meanwhile, across the way, Harley is talking to her potted plant, telling Poison Ivy that she's trying to be one of the good guys. Mr. J was planning on some real bad things. She even shot him in the head. Hopefully soon they'll be back together. There's so much that she has to tell her. She'll be a better person then, or she'll be dead. As Clown Hunter swings his bat, Harley jumps over and he asks her, "Do you really talk to plants?" And Harley dodges another swing, telling him, "Sure, sometimes helps to get the inside thoughts outside. Old trick from when I used to be on the other end. Also helps to keep your brain together. Like when I'm trying to figure out why a weird teenager is breaking into my apartment trying to kill me." Clown Hunter pulls his bat back, asking, "How do you know I'm a teenager?" And Harley asks, "Really? Did you think someone would mistake you for a grown-up? You stink like a teenager. You got a bit of growing up to do. Also make sure you get some deodorant." Clown Hunter swings again, missing, and Harley laughs. "And you're half good at this." Clown Hunter says that he's got a lot of practice on a friend staining the bat. And Harley bursts out laughing. "You're what? Love it. You're a funny kid." She then steps back. "Look, I'm pretty used to people trying to kill me and all. The whole thing is kind of old at this point, though. Now, I'd kill you myself, but that definitely won't fly with one of the good guys. Definitely won't fly with old pointy ears." Clown Hunter steps in asking, "You want to be one of the good guys? How many people have you killed? How many more did you watch the Joker kill?" Just as Clown Hunter closes in, Harley gives him a swift knee to the groin, telling him, "I'm not trying to live in the past. It's all about finding my potential, and my future is looking shiny and bright." At that moment, Batman comes crashing through the window, and as he gets up, he tells Clown Hunter, "I told you to run!" Clown Hunter starts to get back up, telling him, "Not until I finish what I started!" But before he could finish, Harley kicks him in the face, telling him, "Don't be mad, Bats. I didn't kill him or anything. I was doing what you hero types do." Batman collapses onto the floor with Harley seeing two swords sticking out of his back. "Oh, you've been stabbed. Those swords are cool as shit." Ghostmaker then jumps through the window with Harley asking, "And who are you supposed to be?" And after he says his name, she tells him, "That is a dumb name." Ghostmaker fires a trank dart into Harley's neck, stating, "I really hate this city." Batman begins to pick himself up as he bleeds, telling him, "I'm not perfect. This city is dangerous and I can always do better." And the Ghostmaker asks, "Really? The boy killed 24 people in the midst of Joker's last attack. And you are protecting him! The boy needs a permanent solution! The Clown Hunter is only 17 years old. He watched his parents die in front of him, damn it!" And Ghostmaker tells him, "Ah, there it is. As always, you let your emotions get in the way of the work." Ghostmaker fires another dart into Batman, telling him, "I'm taking you off the field. And then I'm going to show you what Gotham can be with a real crime fighter in charge." A short while later, Batman groans as he's being stitched up on an operating table, and Ghostmaker tells him, "There you are. I was wondering when you'd wake. I went a bit light on the anesthetic." Batman looks over and sees Harley and Clown Hunter on the table, asking, "Where?" And Ghostmaker tells him, "Don't play games. You could draw a map of the exact room we're in which abandoned wing. You could tell what year this expansion was built on the concrete alone." Batman struggles at his restraints. "Arkham." And Ghostmaker tells him, "That's right. I brought you to the one place that Batman belongs." Meanwhile, over at Bloodhaven, Nightwing says that he's coming back tonight, and Barbara tells him that that's not why she called. She wants to know everything. Batman's been out of communication for 6 hours, and things keep happening all over the city. All these crimes are being taken care of, and it's almost scary. Nightwing tells her that he can't believe the Ghostmaker actually came to Gotham. She won't find any records on him, not from the clock tower at least. Barbara asks, "Who is he?" So Nightwing tells her, "I only met him once. It was a long time ago, and me and Batman were chasing some low-bit player. It wasn't the Penny Plunderer, but someone on that level. We were flying the Batjet to stop the crook from fleeing the country, and when we landed, he was standing there. Batman got out and they talked. They yelled a bit, but I couldn't hear them. When Batman got back in, he said that the Ghostmaker will finish the job and see the crook extradited back to Gotham. But after that, Batman got upset and punched the controls. He said that he was sorry. And when I asked who that man was, Batman said that he's the most selfish, arrogant person that he's ever met. Long ago, they used to be friends, back when he was honing his craft of crime fighting. There was so much to learn back then, it was a lonely road. Until he met one young man. He too had been making his way around the world wanting to become the greatest crime fighter in the world, but his ego was unbearable. But they both thought exactly the same. They'd stay up late, night after night, talking about the skills that they wanted to learn, the sort of technology that they'd hoped might exist in their adult lives. They'd come up with unsolvable mysteries and pit themselves against each other, trying to stump each other. He hadn't had a real friend in years. He didn't allow himself to. So one night he finally decided to tell the Ghostmaker who he was and why he was fighting. And he told him about the night that his parents died. He told him about the oath and the mission. Batman looked over the window of the jet, and after a brief pause, he says that the Ghostmaker was mad. He tried to kill him. He said that he was weak, that he should be doing this for the art of it, not some childish idea of vengeance. Over the next few years, the Ghostmaker would try to prove his way was better, that he could be a better crime fighter. And at the end of it all, he told Ghostmaker not to set foot in Gotham. Wasn't his city, and they agreed. So this time, he'll get to be the bad guy and send him home. Dick told him that he wasn't weak, and Batman said he knew. But when asked if he missed his friend, Batman paused and said, yes. Back in Arkham City, Clown Hunter begins to wake up woozily asking, am I drunk? Is this what being drunk feels like? Harley says, you're not one of the popular teens, are you? You were drugged, put into a nice, throbbing chemical sleep. Some people pay good money for it. Clown Hunter yells for her to shut up. Batman sits up telling them both, be quiet. And as the Clown Hunter sits up, he says that he isn't in restraints and he asks if this is some sort of trick. He then gets up walking towards Harley asking if he's really doing this now. She hasn't run with the Joker's crew in years. He can't pin all this crap on her. Batman tells her that she was there the night the Joker killed his parents. Clown Hunter looks at the sword left behind and as he reaches for it, Batman shouts for him not to do it. And the Clown Hunter takes the sword, holding it above Harley's head, telling her, I'm sorry. I've been waiting for this chance for a long time and I'm going to make it hurt. As the Clown Hunter positions himself to kill Harley, Batman tells him to drop the sword. We can talk this out! And the Clown Hunter laughs that there's already been too much talking. Batman says that they're being played. He's a pawn in the Ghostmaker's plans. If he kills Harley, Ghostmaker will come in and kill him to teach a lesson about caring for people. Clown Hunter says that he doesn't care about him, and Batman tells him, yes, he does. He knows his pain. He knows the want to make things right. This is the wrong way to do it. Clown Hunter begins to lift the sword, telling him, maybe, he just doesn't care. And Batman uses all of his strength to snap the bindings on his wrist, throwing a batarang towards Harley Quinn. She catches it, cutting the strap around her wrist, and then Batman jumps up, grabbing the sword, stopping the Ghost Hunter, telling Harley Quinn to get the heck out of here. Harley tells him, I'm not going anywhere. And as the Clown Hunter picks up another knife, he asks, why? Are you stupid? She tells him that sometimes people think so, but I'm not. My brain works a little sideways, sure, but it's a good brain, and I know how you feel. Clown Hunter yells, no, you don't! And Harley says that it used to be her job to know how people feel. Something he's going to learn is that there are lots of different paths to growing up. Most of them will be crap, but she needs him to hear something, and then he can try and kill her. She doesn't remember much the night of his parents, but it doesn't matter. She's done plenty of bad things. If Batman says that she was there, then she was there. And she is sorry that his parents died, and she is sorry that she had any hand in it. She's sorry that it got so deep in his head that it messed him up, and now he's out here ruining his life to try and make sense of it all, and he's got a whole life ahead of him. She was really messed up for a while. Nothing in her life felt like it made any sense, and there was a guy telling her everything that she wanted to hear. He made her think that he was a broken person, in the exact way that she thought she was a broken person, that he had built this shell to protect himself. That he had painted on this grin. He made everyone afraid and that it was all their fault for making them feel that way. She wanted to be strong, and he was able to manipulate her and control her and make her feel loved enough that she was willing to help him do really terrible things because she wanted to be strong too. Harley wipes away a tear and smiles, stating that she is going to be dealing with the consequences of that for her entire life. She is always going to be Harley Quinn. She's going to try and save as many people as she did hurt back in the day. And she wants to be a better version of herself. And if he wants to kill her, he can. She deserves it. Clown Hunter holds the knife to Harley's neck, and Batman steps forward with Harley quickly telling him, stand back! It's the kid's choice, Batman! Clown Hunter's hand begins to tremble, and he pulls back the knife, slamming it onto the table beside Harley. Batman reaches out, but Clown Hunter leaves, telling him, just leave me alone! Harley asks if he can make sure the kid ends up okay. And Batman tells her, I'll do everything in my power, but right now you need to get out of here. I'm going to have a few words with an old friend. Ghostmaker walks up stating that he can catch the boy, and Batman tells him, of course you can. Clown Hunter is a teenager with a baseball bat and almost no combat experience. Ghostmaker slashes and Batman deflects it and he says, you have had so many chances to kill Harley Quinn over the years. How easy would it have been to just eliminate one of Joker's closest associates? But nobody learns. Nobody changes. Nobody is better in the end. Ghostmaker swipes, cutting into Batman's back, telling him, not everyone can be saved. You are protective of a boy because of your parents. You empathize with that boy's dream. Batman swings his elbow up, hitting Ghostmaker in the chin, telling him, we're not teenagers anymore. We're getting older, and I'm not done trying to save this city. I also recognize Clown Hunter's situation as a man who has helped a lot of wayward young people find better paths. Caring about people hasn't killed me yet. The two step back and they resume their stances, and Batman tosses the sword on the ground, telling him, "I don't want to fight. We've been fighting for too long." Ghostmaker picks up his swords, throwing them up and into their sheaths. "Fine. We don't have to fight. I'll leave Gotham in the morning and we stick to our old agreement. However, it's too bad. I was hoping to come here and have one of those cars come flying in. Always jealous of them." Batman laughs. "I'm building a new one. Not flying, though. Built for speed and maneuvering the streets." Ghostmaker asks, "Not a tank?" Batman tells him, "No, not a tank." Ghostmaker opens the window and gets ready to climb out, telling him, "I'll be watching on the ghost net." And Batman tells him, "You don't have to. What if you don't leave Gotham? Stay here. We can make it better." Ghostmaker asks him, "Why?" And Batman goes on telling him, "Because we're getting older as the city gets younger. I don't have the resources that I used to or the allies within the law enforcement, city, and government. I could use some help." Ghostmaker pauses for a moment thinking, "I'm not going to stop telling you that you're wrong." Batman puts on his shirt. "Good. Since Alfred passed, I haven't had enough of that." Ghostmaker goes on telling him, "I'm not wearing a bat on my chest." And Batman tells him, "I wouldn't have asked. The only rule is that there's no killing in Gotham. It makes the job much harder. But if that's not too much of a risk..." Ghostmaker laughs. "Is that how it is? Guess I'll accept your challenge. Also, your family's out there waiting to beat me after death. I was gonna let them watch. Thought maybe they could learn something if they lost you." Batman tells him, "Oh, I know. I gave them the signal to stand back. You should come meet them." Ghostmaker tells him that he would, but he actually got an alert from Oracle. Just as he lowered the ghost net blocking her computer, the Circus of the Strange just hijacked the Gotham City Orchestra. The two look at each other, and Ghostmaker says, "I'd wager who could get to the orchestra faster." Then Batman begins running. "I'll take that bet." Ghostmaker then tells him, "Actually, I'm richer than you now." And Batman again responds, "Good. Means you'll be buying dinner." And there you have it, the Ghostmaker storyline, essentially Batman's new Alfred. What do you guys think about this? The Bat Family is going to be a big central point for DC moving forward. I mean, honestly, we all kind of expected it. But yeah, what do you guys think? Overall, let me know in the comments down below. What do you think of the new character of Clown Hunter? What do you think of Harley Quinn being a good guy? What do you think of the Ghostmaker? Seriously, I want your opinions. And don't forget, you can find us over at Patreon, patreon.com/comicstorian, where you'll get early access to a lot of our content right here at the Comic Storian channel. With that out of the way, if you did enjoy the video, please consider hitting like and subscribe. And I will see you tomorrow right here at Comic Storian.